peace and happiness. And you must see to it that their energies are put to proper positive use for his betterment, for the betterment of the society, for the betterment of the country. That is the distinction between a religion and a culture, I always feel. Everybody should feel proud of their religion, nothing wrong. Everybody should be a good Christian, good Muslim, good Hindu. There is no need to denigrate others. That's not allowed according to our system. And our people, many people say constitution has given us secularism, all are equal. I have another viewpoint. It is late, constitution came later, na? Secularism came to constitution later. But secularism is safe, strong in India because it is in the DNA of all the Indians, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region. We are all one Indians. We may be Malayalis, we may be Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Punjabi, Assami, Bhojpuri. We may be speaking different languages. We must also feel proud, yes. But we must all remember that we are sons of one soil. That's why I always tell my friends, in my own way, I tell youngsters to remember five things. One, mother, the mother who has given you this beautiful birth, should never forget her. Second, Janma Bhumi, the place where you are born, you should never, never forget your native place. Third, the mother tongue, the language that has come from a mother's womb, the great Malayala, or Tamil, or Telugu, you should never forget it, and at home, you should speak in your own mother tongue only. And fourth is the motherland, the country where you are born. You are not educated simply because of the fees which you have paid. It is because of society and the country. The entire country is one. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. We are one nation, one people. And lastly, we must also remember that the guru who has given us the knowledge and the wisdom, these gurus, who has given us the wisdom and knowledge should never be forgotten. You may have a lot of technology, you may have IT, you may have even internet, you also have now Google. Knowledge is available, Google is very useful. But I can tell you, Google can never replace Guru. Guru gives knowledge and we should respect Guru. So mother, native place, Janma Bhumi, mother tongue, and then your motherland, and then guru. These five things should be remembered forever throughout our life. That should be the noble duty of all of us. I hope all the youngsters, they all follow the same. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, said, I quote, "The golden rule of conduct is mutual toleration, respecting each other. Seeing that we will never all think alike and we shall always see truth in fragment and from different angles of vision. Even amongst the most conscious persons, there will be room enough for honest difference of opinion. The only possible rule of conduct in any civilized society is therefore mutual toleration, mutual admiration. That is what is required in a country. As we remember these ennobling statements and recognize today the outstanding work done by the two of the blessed sons of India, we have a rejuvenated sense of well-being. We feel a new energy is pervading in ourselves and the world around us, a positive energy, a source of harmony, understanding, respect, a perennial fountain head of the timeless values that India has stood for. It is time to nourish these roots. It is time to rediscover the treasure within churches, temples, mosques, gurudwaras and other religious shrines are places of devotion. They are pious places of spiritual regeneration and catalyst of intergenerational transmission of cultural values. They are potentially the sites of social and community education. So long as they fulfill this role, they serve to bring people together. However, if they stray from this path and dabble in other things and unnecessarily get into other divisive statements, they become dysfunctional. I hope these two stands of religion and politics are not mixed. Politics is important. Religion also is important. And religious leaders give spiritual guidance to every human being, and the political leaders take inspiration from our noble heritage to provide clean polity. What we should learn from these great souls is cleanliness, pious thoughts, humbleness, and doing something good for the society. We should always think, share and care. Share what you got with others. Care. Someone may say, sir, I have nothing, no cash. Sharing is not cash alone. Share the knowledge. Share the wisdom. Share the expertise. Share the experience. Share the service. Then you will be caring for others. So share and care should be our guidance. And we should all live like that. We should live for others, not for ourselves. These great souls, noble sons, they lived for others. To emancipate from people from ignorance, to guide the humanity to a proper path, that should be an ideal. That should be an ideal. So there should be always a sort of a clear-cut mark of difference between politics and religion. I always feel that in public, taking advantage of situation, I always say the leader should be selected, elected, chosen on the basis of four things: character, caliber, capacity, and conduct. But unfortunately, some people are trying to replace these four C's by caste, community, cash, and criminality. These four C's are going to spoil us. You will not get good people. If you have people with character, caliber, capacity, and conduct, discipline, dynamism, dedication, and devotion, then you will have promotion of the country. Otherwise, you will have commotion in the country. One should remember that. Friends, this is an occasion for the process of recognizing goodness, recognizing the spirit of creating a heaven on earth through pious thoughts and rigorous actions. Once again, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be part of this event. I feel blessed today for having come over here. I had a very meaningful time here. Kurianji told me my logistics are working in such a way, either I take lunch in Kochi and then come here and then address the meeting. I told them it's better I come little early, spend some time with these noble souls, and also I had the good occasion of eating and meeting and greeting. And resting also in the bishop's house. I am told normally the vice president and all, you know, there are protocols laid down. I said, okay, no problem. What is there? We are meeting pious people and I am staying in a house which is a center of service. So there should not be any problem, because my people were little this thing, sir, all the security and all. But I said nothing. I am more secure inside that house. Don't worry on that count. And to prove my point, I came back secured also. I will be going back secured. There won't be any problem on that count. So friends, it's a very good occasion for me, really. We should think in terms of advancement of humanity through enlightenment, through knowledge. Education is one contribution given by the missionaries in Kerala. Education do not mean only for employment. Education is for enhancement of knowledge. Education is for emancipation. Education is for enlightenment. Education is for empowerment. And education is for employment also. So that sort of education has been given. It's very good. And then what we require is that the country has a great future. Bright future. And it's moving forward. You just see what is happening across the globe. The world economy is slowing down. Our powerful neighbor, China, also going a little negative. The only economy which is forward-looking is India, that is Bharat. We should all feel proud of the same. And that I was minister till some time. And people, 35 ambassadors came and met me and told me they want to invest in India. World Bank, World Economic Forum, Moody's ratings, not Modi ratings, Moody's ratings. Everybody is saying India is a safe place for investments. So we as a society, we must all join together to make our country stable and strong and prosperous. Prosperous for inclusive growth. People who are The last line, antima pankti mein jo baithe, unka uttan, uplifting the poorest of the poor, the downtrodden, the neglected, the unrecognized, that should be the priority for all of us. Respecting woman, respecting the other creatures of God, and also respecting trees. Everything has to be kept in mind. Respecting trees, nature, culture for a better future, that has to be remembered. Nature, culture for a better future. I'm very happy that the Marthoma Church has taken up this environmental issue also. Environment is for our protection, not for somebody's sake. So these are all areas where the entire society should be guided, should be motivated. I'm happy that the Marthoma Church is doing this great job in a more meaningful and constructive manner. I convey my best wishes. And finally, my friends, one word about my friend, Professor P.J. Kurian. I feel really honored that I'm invited here on this occasion at the initiative of Professor P.J. Kurian, who is my dear colleague of mine, and more than that, a person with whom I have shared my light moments in otherwise grave situations, and whose company I would always cherish in Parliament. You know, in Parliament, sometimes there will be tension, less attention, obstruction, not construction. So, it happens. But we exchange our ideas, because Parliament is there to discuss and debate. His Highness was telling me that this is also a Parliament Hall, Convention Center. Parliament is a symbol of Indian democracy. So we have to follow the principles of Parliament, either you talk out or walk out, no breakout. If you have continuous breakout, then it will be all out. No doubt about the same. If there is, in democracy, you put point, your fourth of point of view, other man put forth of his point of view, discuss, debate and decide, but not disturb. I always tell people, government proposes, opposition oppose. Let the government propose, opposition oppose, let the house dispose. That should be the democratic method. Mr. Professor Kurian is a great personality and a wonderful human being, in spite of grave provocations in the house. You have seen how many times he never lost his temper. His service to the nation as a social worker, educationalist, politician and parliamentarian are truly outstanding. When Professor Kurian first entered the portals of Parliament 38 years ago, he was only 39 years old. In 1980, he came to the Parliament as a member of the Lok Sabha and was a member of that house for 6 consecutive terms from 80 to 99. He was then elected to Rajya Sabha in the January 2005 and served the house for 3 terms. Thus, he has a vast experience of serving both Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha for nearly 4 decades. As the Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha, he tried to find means to enable the effective functioning of the House with passion and energy. I hope he will become Chairman also in future as and when an opportunity comes. I have no problem. To desist from a confrontationist approach. Everyone knows how he conducted the proceedings of the House in a dignified manner. I also share his views that the existing rules also need to change to effectively deal with disruptions in the upper house. It is delightful to acknowledge that I received maximum possible guidance and cooperation from him. Because without the cooperation of the members and the deputy chairman, you cannot effectively function. That's why day one I told them, my operation depends on your cooperation. Otherwise there will be separation. With this wide and in-depth knowledge of the rules and procedure of the working of the house, Professor Kurian has given me the best suggestions and advice as and when required and helped me immensely in delivering my duties and responsibilities as the chairman of the Rajya Sabha. I am learning a lot from him, and it's always a pleasure and honor to meet Professor Kurian and learn new things from him. I would like to state this with pride today at this place that Professor Kurian's commendable administrative and political experience has earned him respect not only in the Rajya Sabha but the entire country. This is what I wanted to say on this occasion. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Honorable Vice President, for enrapturing us with your enlightening thoughts. As a token of our gratitude, the late trustee and treasurer of the Marthoma Church, Sri P.P. Achengunj, will now present the memento to our chief guest, the Honorable Vice President, Sri M. Venkaiah Naidu, And I most respectfully request the Honorable Chief Guest to receive the same. Martuma Sabha Admaya Trustee, Sri P.P. Achengunya, Ippol Vishishta Adhidike, Memento Nalgunadana. Thank you, sir. I cordially invite the Reverend K.G. Joseph, Sabha Secretary of the Martama Church, to propose the vote of thanks.
Malangara Martama Suryani Sabhaki Deva Nalgi Anungrihida Varaprada Vara Danangalaya Palbam Ocean Jadava. Avivendian Dr. Philippos Marcus Sostam Martama Valia Metropolita Tirimenuda Nutionan Janmadan Ravilum. Malangara Martoma Suryani Saviade Varamadishana Avivani Doctor Joseph Martoma Metropolita Tirimenuda Pata the Vajra Jovil in Ravilum Animodi Chadrikina Yimaha Samelanum Namadi India Sarva Dharaniya Uparashtrapati Sri Vengayanai Rujide Mahini Asanidalum Saneshatalum Yere Adrikipudagim Rashtatanadana Sreda Kendrimai Ithanya Dimashangal Margain Sidu Nadil Malangara Martoma Suryani Savike Abhimanavum Sardarthiumunda. We are very much indebted to His Excellencies Sri Venkaiya Naidu Ji, Honorable Vice President of India, for His esteemed presence, challenging message, and best wishes to both of our Metropolitans. On behalf of the Malangara Martoma Syrian Church, I extend our sincere gratitude to Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiya Naidu Ji. Devan Nalgia, Nioga Vadigal, Eo Samelatil, Anungraha, Anumodangal, Etuangi, Sabhirim, Samukatin de Hurdingal, Sneha Pradishta Nadia, Nutiona, Janmadan attended Hanadil Arik and Avivania Palmavushin, Doctor Philippos Marcus Sostam Martoma, Vali Metropolita, Tiriminudum, Kalinya Aruba the Vashangal, Patata Sitrushade, Ajayamaya Karma Chaitanyatil, Jolikinam, Nedru Padangal, Savike Samanija. Yogatil Adishabadavi Alangarich Martoma Sava Paramadishin Abhivaniya Doctor Joseph Martoma Metropolita Tirimeni Udula Hrudayangamayanani Arikinum E. Samelanatil Asham Sagalar Picha Martoma Savide Priya Putrinum Rajasava Deputy Chairmanumaya Professor P. J. Kurian Sarnum Martoma Savide Priya Mitrabum Kerala Tinde Munmukimandri Mai Umman Chandik Sarnum Malangara Yakomaya Suryani Savide Senate Secretary Sneha Vivandinaya, Doctor Joseph Mark Gregorios Tirimenikum, Sanadiangunda, Y Samalanam Thanimakia, Martoma Sabiuda Priya Putrinum, Kerala Samstana, Jela Bifova Vaupamandri Maya, Advocate Matuti Thomasinum, Pranamba Pratna, Nirvahicha Malangara Orthodox Suryani Sabiuda Niranam Badra Asana Divan, Avivania Doctor Johanan Mar Chrysostomos Tirimenikum, Samavana Pratna, Nirvahikin, the Malangara Catholica Sava, Tirivala Druba, the Archbishop. Abhivaniya Doctor Thomas Makulas Tirimenikim, Swagadapasanganati Abba Martoma Sava Mumbai, Badrasan Addition, Doctor Givaris Martyrovish Tirimenikim, Savail Abhivanira, Matatirimeni Markum, Sahodri Savagal Tirimeni Markum, Savail Ubaharam Samar Pija, Savat Vesti,